Hi, House of the Dragon fans. Welcome back to Tori Talks with Dr. S. I'm Tori, and this is Dr. S. We're going to talk about Season 1, Episode 8 of House of the Dragons. It's called The Lord of the Tides, because we need a new one.
We possibly. Do. Possibly.
It hasn't even happened yet.
It's very, I know, but how do they know that he may be injured? It's like a rumor?
How did they find out? I don't know. This is 6 years later.
Yeah.
They went back, and I don't know why they started this war again. But anyway, yeah, so how do they know? Just
because he hasn't come back or something?
Well, they know that the wound is causing a fever.
So messages are being sent. Is that
like
what that
a
little,
raven
is that what
a
little paper said?
I think that's what that means. Yeah, that's
how they...
Because
I couldn't read it.
I couldn't read either.
I was trying, but it was really small.
Yes, well, this excites his brother, Aemond.
Yes.
Not, I know he loves his brother, but it means like, oh, well, we're going to have to find another...
Oh, maybe me.
Sure, Cinderella.
Why
drift
you?
Mark. Yeah, geez, relax. Sit down.
Everyone needs
He's
to
not
calm
even cold
down.
Yet. So then everybody's going to question, you know, who should inherit the title of the Lord of the Tides. But so then we see Rhaenyra, because again, 6 years later, her and Daemon are like, you know, happy little couple. She is pregnant.
Aww.
She's already had two other babies.
Yeah, she's busy.
The blonde babies. Mm-hmm. Yes, and her father, the king, is not doing well at all. Like, he's on hospice, in my opinion.
He's a skeleton.
Oof. That now, when... talk about special effects.
Dang.
What?
That was good job, guys.
Good job.
With the hole in his face and no eye.
Eye socket.
And he looked like he was just talking normal.
Oh my gosh. And the actor did a great job. He's so emaciated.
Oh
my God. Wow. So yeah, he's not doing well. So basically the queen, Alicent, and her dad, the Hand, are ruling things. Mm-hmm. But you know, I have never been more neutral in my life about a Game of Thrones. I usually take sides.
Yeah.
I like to take sides.
Mm-hmm.
But I see her points. I see Rhaenyra's points.
I agree.
Yeah, and I can see why she's not ruling. I don't feel like she's, like, overdoing anything. She's not, like, ordering crazy things.
No.
Someone has to stand in, right?
Yes.
So
mm-hmm.
I understand.
Yeah. So far, she's not doing anything crazy.
I know, but the most extreme thing she did was wanting to take an eye for an eye.
Yeah.
But seems like she's maybe calmed down a little
yeah.
bit.
Yeah, but did you notice, though, the seven-pointed star thing, like the religious thing?
No.
Okay, so when Daemon and Rhaenyra walk in and they notice, like, oh, things look different here.
Yeah.
So I didn't really catch it either, but, you know, I like to watch those scenes at the end.
Oh, tell
and
me.
So Alicent has found religion. I think it's the same religion from, like, Game of Thrones, you know, the whole,
oh.
yeah, like the seven-pointed star thing.
Oh, wow.
Right?
Great
so,
catch.
And I think that's to, like, they said, like, to compensate for, like, how bad she got when she, like, cut Rhaenyra and wanted to take the kid's
gotcha.
Eye. So to like atone for it, she's like found religion in
oh,
this way.
Okay.
So, but then that's probably going to turn her bad too, because everyone who followed the religion
yeah.
Is not a good idea.
Yeah.
Right?
Glad she wanted to get better.
Anyway,
so basically, so like they have a lot of work to do. They have to figure out who's going to take over Driftmark and then who's going to take over, because still we're questioning who the heir is, who the rightful heir should be, but after, you know, so Rhaenyra, the two boys she has from someone else.
Right.
And, yes, so
don't
they...
Don't say it. Even you know that you shouldn't say
I'm
it.
I'm not going to say anything. But yeah, so basically we have to have a petition to say, like, who's going to take over Driftmark and just, let's just all, like, hash it out, right? So it was a really touching moment when she goes to her father to say, you need to defend me. But she knows he's in this fragile state.
Yeah.
But she's like, but he's kind of altered, and they're, like, definitely giving him medication.
Yes.
Like, I know he's in pain. It's probably terminal pain. But,
yes.
yeah, and then, you know, you don't even expect it. But when it starts, the petitioning, here he comes. Hobbling,
wow.
dragging his body.
It's amazing. Anytime somebody is like the last one to walk through those doors, like when Alicent came through the doors, you know it's significant.
Yeah, and they really let us watch him walk that whole way. They didn't just like speed it up and then and then Daemon helps him onto the throne, which you could tell he's really bothered by it, because when they first enter like his bedroom area, he kind of hangs back, like, I don't know if I'm ready to see my brother like this, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That was sweet though, right?
Yes, it was really nice. It was a nice moment.
I know. Okay, so basically Aemond it's not Aemond, it's Vaymond. I don't like you saying Aemond. Vaymond, sorry. He gets a little ugly, and he's just insistent, but then the king's like, how dare you even, like, say
question.
So then,
Why are they petitioning for something that should be a done deal? It should be a done deal, right?
That's what I'm saying. He's like, I don't understand what we're talking about here.
The only reason it isn't is because of the appearance of her children, which don't look like the Valerians.
Right.
We get that already. We already know that you're not supposed to say that. It's treason.
Yes. So, Vaemon says, without remorse, that the children are bastards and she's a whore. So, the king, I know, that was cute. Like, good try. He's like, oh, I'm going to cut you. But then, no, leave it to Daemon to cut off most of his head.
So, the king says to take his tongue. You should lose your tongue. And Daemon's like, no, I'm just going to cut off your head and leave the tongue.
Yeah. You can keep your tongue.
And then when they showed his body later, like, embalming it or whatever, and it's, like, all drained of fluid, but you see his tongue and the brain. That was amazing.
The special effects were
so good.
I'm really impressed.
Don't waste
with.
Any details.
Yes, no, that's okay. So there's a lot of strife going on with this family. So I feel like in Viserys's last, like, you know, last moments, he wants to like everybody to make peace, or at least so he can see it, so he can go in
peace.
Let's
break bread.
Yes, let's literally have a last supper, and so everybody's there, and then they start like toasting to each other, and well, he takes his mask off first, and that's when we see
his real condition. Yeah.
Yes, and so we have a very classy toast from Rhaenyra saying, like, she makes a good point that Alicent has stuck by her father's side and taken care of
him.
That
was very nice. I was like, oh.
Very mature.
Maybe this will end well because they'll be friends again.
Yes, and she does seem a little taken aback by it and kind of emotional about it, appreciative, and then and then there's all this praising going on. But let's not forget these little idiot kids.
These children who are supposedly, we time jumped so that they can be older and more mature and young adults. Nah, dude.
No, acting like it. I almost said a-holes. But yeah, Aegon like rapes the servant girl and then
they kill her?
I thought they paid her off and then they gave her the morning after tea.
Well, so I thought so too, but then where was she? I think somebody was asking for her, like, hey, where's Diana?
Wasn't that his wife that was asking for the girl or whatever?
But she was gone.
They probably did the right thing and let her go. Like, maybe? No?
You think Allison did the right thing and let her go?
I don't know. I really felt like she was like holding her like...
Oh, no.
I don't know why.
Oh, so no, no. Oh, no, there's no way.
No.
Now think about it. She was like, oh, you're not going to tell anybody, but you already told so-and-so and so-and-so, and I'm the third person that you've told. Drink this tea. It'll be fine.
I thought it was just
to
make sure that...
I think... Yeah, I know the tea that you're referring to, the tea that was given to Rhaenyra. That was the
tea.
And
then she paid her off.
Yeah, but I don't know.
No? Okay.
I mean, maybe.
No, I know.
Maybe.
I'm giving her too much credit.
I just feel like... Allison's not going to take chances with, like, is that enough money? I don't know.
That's true.
I don't know.
That's true.
Maybe they gave her the money to, like, make it look like they were paying her off so she wouldn't know that she was about to die. But, yeah, I mean, I guess she could have run off with the money. Like, maybe it's all to interpretation.
That's true. But hope she's okay.
Yeah, but I don't think Allison trusted her after. She already told three people.
Yeah.
In, like... You know, a couple hours.
The people she needed to tell.
I mean, I would have told people too.
Yeah.
Yeah, but.
That's awful.
Yeah.
So the kids are kind of like fighting a little bit, and then, but I like that, like, Jace is not really letting, like, Aegon and Aemon bother him, and, like, he's trying to be, like, snidey about, like, because he's betrothed to, you know, cousins? I can't keep track of this. But yeah, so anyway.
But technically, they're not really related.
Right.
Right. So, yeah.
Technically, they are.
So, I support them. I support that coupling, actually.
Oh, my gosh.
Right. Let me piece it together in my head. No, I don't think they're related.
Yeah, they're not.
Yeah.
You're right.
I mean, maybe way back.
That's true.
Who knows?
I don't know. But either way, it really does come together. You kind of see King Viserys admiring everybody and just, like, taking it all in. And I just want to say... My dad, when he was older, before he died, I remember I'd catch him across the room looking and admiring. So it's like, I feel like they sometimes you know when you're like close to death. So yes. Then I also really like that they showed him on his deathbed, literally. And so Alicent goes in and then he thinks that is Rhaenyra and they're talking about like, he said that Prince Aegon and she's like, oh, like your son? And they're like, he should be king. And so now that's all, like, messed up.
Okay, so this is what I think is hilarious. So Rhaenyra already asked him, right? Like, do you think the whole Song of Fire and Ice is real? He didn't answer her, right? Mm-hmm. So then Alicent comes, and he's all delusional. He thinks that it's Rhaenyra. And so he says, oh, let me answer that question. But it's not Rhaenyra. It's Alicent. So now Alicent hears little bits of the story. And now they almost had a reconciliation, right? Because Rhaenyra said those nice things about Alicent, but now they both think that they're the ones who are supposed to stop the ice people.
Yeah.
So basically, what's being told to us now is that the whole Game of Thrones that we know, the Song of Fire and Ice, was basically like a misunderstanding. Like, basically an episode of Three's Company. Are you kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me?
All of this is because of this.
Because of this moment.
Oh my gosh. Ooh.
What the heck?
Thanks for putting that into perspective, Dr. S. Wow.
I was literally like, wait, is that what you're telling me?
You're kidding me.
This was just misunderstanding. Everything could have been fine. Like, Allison could have just been on Team Rhaenyra.
It didn't have to get this.
And then it would have been
ugly.
Not as fun of a story.
I think that's exactly what they're saying.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, he does ultimately die. Did you notice right before he dies, he says, my love? Because I think he sees his wife again. His first wife.
Oh, I love that.
But I do like that they played it out and they like had him in the dark and then he takes his last breath. And I liked that. Yeah. They did really good. Mm-hmm. So, wow. A little bit of a mess going on now here. So I didn't see a preview for next week. Did you see a preview for the next episode?
I did, but I don't remember anything stand out. I just know I'm very curious to see what happens with not Aegon, but the other kid with the eye.
Aemond,
because he seems like, I don't know, I kind of like, I'm interested in his character now.
Oh, he's devious.
Oh, he's terrible. Yeah. But he seems to be more powerful than Aegon.
Yeah, right? I agree.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So like, I feel like, and they highlighted him so many times in this episode that I feel like he's going to do something important.
For sure.
And I don't know what.
He's going to be trouble.
Yeah, and I hope it's not like killing children. Because why do Rhaenyra's kids, the strong, they're so strong. He's like, they're so... I'm just saying they're strong. What a jerk.
So obnoxious.
Why do they look so young still?
Yeah, I thought the same thing.
I know,
thing.
Like you aged up the other ones, but not them. I think
right.
just to
they
like
look really
infantilize them, I guess.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. I don't know, but we only have two episodes left. Gonna have to wrap this all up in a bow. All right, everybody, let us know what you thought of this episode of House of the Dragons. Please comment below and like and subscribe. And then we'll see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye.